before I do begin, I'd like to ask you, how's your vision at the moment? Feeling a little, still a little blurry, hasn't cleared up completely yet. Okay, let me just go ahead and set some gloves on. Just the pillow for you, okay? Let's have you a little bit more upright. Okay. There we go. Should be a little better for you, okay? Just gonna hold your eyelid open, okay? I'm just gonna gently pass this over your eye. Shouldn't hurt or sting at all. Should just help your vision clear up a little bit, alright? Okay, and let's get the other eye. And that should help you out just a little bit. If it's not 100% clear, just give it a couple seconds, okay? Go ahead and throw that out. Okay. So while your vision goes ahead and clears up, I'm just going to let you know that during the surgery, everything went well. Everything went pretty normal. We understand that you had a pretty bad accident, and we're trying to take the best care of you, okay? So, how are you feeling at this moment? Okay. Very good, very good. So, in the likelihood that you most likely don't remember, we did take x-rays, and just so you know, we understand that you had, I'll quickly show you, hopefully you can understand just a little bit maybe. This is your skull, and as you can see here, we had just a little bit of a problem right here under your orbital bone in your eye. We also found several things inside of your skull, but we were able to remove those, okay? And we were able to fix your eye as well. So that's why you might have a bit of a numbing sensation here. Okay. As well as while you had the surgery you did. But like I said, you have nothing to worry about. You look pretty much as you did before the surgery. And all you need is some time to heal. Okay. So if at any moment during this examination you feel that you need to rest, you can go ahead and close your eyes, and just take a breather, okay? Very well. So are you feeling better? Can you see better now? Excellent. Okay. So I'm just going to actually take a look at your eyes, okay? First, before I do continue, are you feeling comfortable in this position? Okay, very good, very good. And usually, I ask my patients to square up with me, but as today you're not feeling too well, I will be squaring up with you and making sure that I'm directly in front of you and making sure that you are in the best possible care possible, okay? So, if you will, please just try to maintain your head perfectly still and focus on my chin. Okay, excellent. So you're looking right here. I'm actually going to hold up my two fingers so it makes it a little easier for you. And I don't want you to look at that this light. Just look right here. Just want to see if your eyes are responding correctly. That's all. Seems like you're doing really well. Very good. Very good. Okay. Okay, excellent. And before I continue on with the examination, I will be taking your temperature just to make sure we're not running a bit of a fever. Very good. And we're going to run that one more time. Excellent. Really good. And I know that we already checked your heart, but better safe than sorry, as I always say. So if you will, just try to relax. And I will just take this in here. Very good, very good. Seems like you're doing really well. Okay. So, I'm just going to go ahead and just take a look around your eye. Make sure that the orbital around your eye is okay. So, all I ask you to do is just remain perfectly still. And if I cause any kind of pain, please let me know. We can always fix that up for you, okay? Just gonna go ahead and touch this side right here, okay? Just going to cover your eye for a moment, just so I can see if it hurts. Okay. Take a look at this side as well. Okay. Very good, very good. Now, if you will let me just take a look at this really quickly. Now, if you could please, could you just blink a few times for me? If you could blink, let's say 4 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. No, no blinking if you're in danger. Nothing like that. Just asking you to blink 4 times for me. Very good. Now, if you will, with just your eyes, I would like you to move them from left to right, up and down. Left, good, right, good, up, good, and down. Now, you can close your eyes for just a moment. Good. And now, when you open them, I want you to focus on me. Very good job. Okay. Now, I'm just going to right over here. Let's just make sure that this doesn't hurt you. Okay, let's just move this just slightly over. There we go. Now, I'm going to move my finger across, and I just want you, with your eyes, just try to focus on my finger only, right here, okay? So you're just going to focus on my finger, and you're just going to follow it. Very good. Just like that. You're doing really well. Excellent. going to place my hands right about here, okay? And all I want you to do is let me know what side moves first, or what side actually moves. How about that? Make it a little easier. Good. 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 Excellent. Relax for just a moment, okay? Okay, so here I have a snowing chart for you, and if you could please, could you just read the first line? And that was the easiest. Very good, very good. And now could you read the third one? Very good. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and use this light at the moment, okay? And we're just gonna see if the light bothers you in any kind of way, all right? So if you will, you're gonna look directly at the light. Okay, very good. And you're just gonna follow it for a little bit, okay? You're doing really well. Very good, very good. Please just follow the light. That's it. Excellent. We're gonna go back. Okay. We're gonna go up and down. Very good. I'm also going to count down. And when I get to zero, you're gonna close your eyes for just a moment, okay? Alright, so here we go. Five. You're still following the light. Very good. Four. Three. Two. One. Zero. Eyes closed. Take a deep breath for me. Good job. And now, once again, please open your eyes. Look at the light. Now you're going to let me know when you cannot see the light because it's out of your peripheral vision. Okay? Once again, you're going to look right here. And here we go. Very good job. Good. Doing really well, okay? Good. Very good. Excellent. Okay. Just gonna cover your eye, okay? Gonna cover one, and we're just gonna see how much tracking you can do with the light, okay? So you're gonna follow the light around with your eye. So I'm just gonna help you out here. Just gonna cover this eye just like this. Very good. And just follow the light. Very good. You're doing really well. Excellent. Okay. And let's go ahead and cover this side now. Okay. Good. And same thing. You're going to follow the light. Very good. Doing well. Seems like your eyes are getting a little bit lost there. Are you having trouble seeing? Having a little bit of trouble? Okay, it's okay. Nothing to be alarmed about. You just came out of surgery, so it's to be expected, okay? You're going to be here for a few days, so we can keep monitoring that for you, right? Here, I have a red button, all right? And with this red button, I am going to start out about here, and I'm just going to move it across your vision, okay? And what you're going to do for me is you're just going to let me know if at any point the color of red changes. So if I start about here, and you see it about a nice bright red, and somewhere around here it turns a little dull, or maybe even orangey color, you let me know, okay? So, I'm just going to ask that you cover your left eye first, okay? You don't have to touch your face, you can just cover it just like that, or you can kind of close it a little bit. That works, okay? And we're going to start here, and we're going to do it just like that. I'll move it a little slow. You're focusing on the red button. How was that? Okay. And any problems there? Okay. Now please cover your right eye now. Good. And now we're going to go the other way. Again, you're focusing on this red button. And how was that? Okay. Very good job. Very good job. Excellent. So, once again, just going to ask that you remain perfectly calm. I'm going to go ahead and just take a look at your eyes a little bit closer. Let me actually grab here. And I just ask that you please just relax, okay? Just gonna take a look. Gonna have a closer look, alright? Just try to look straightforward for me, try to just fixate on one particular spot. If it helps whatsoever, you can go ahead and look at the letter E on the snubbing chart, or if you'd like, you could look at the pair of teeth that I have back there, okay? Usually a fan favorite in the office for people, okay? So I'm going to start out by looking at this side, all right? If you hear anything like this, okay, you have to be alarmed. I'm just switching through the lens, okay? All right, so if you will. Very good. Okay. Eye looks perfect. Very good. Okay. No damage. Very good. Very good. Okay. And I'm just gonna go ahead and reset this. Zero. Very good. And once again, just ask that you please can pick any item here and just make sure that you just try to stay looking at it while I look at this eye. All right. Here we go. Excellent. Okay. Eye seems to be right where we need it. I do see some bruising. Hold my finger right about here. Just look at my finger for me, okay? Perfect. Just look at my finger. Good. Okay. Please look to your left. Very good. And now, very slowly, very good. You did very well there. Thank you very much. Okay. Your eye seems to be responding well so far. Lenses here for you, and what I'm going to ask that you do is just let me know which of the two lenses you felt that you could see a bit better with, okay? I will be taking notes on each one that you select, so all you have to do is tell me which one you thought was better. Remember, there is no right or wrong answer. Very well. It's just to determine how your vision is working at the moment, okay? Here I have a sample, alright, and with this sample, you can see the solid chart, right, in your particular angle. If you'd like, I can actually fix that pillow for you so that you can see the solid chart just a bit better, just like that, okay, how's that, a little better, okay, so, this one is just a sample. But it's just to give you a rough idea of the things that we're going to do. Okay, so here, I'll bring this a little close to you. Actually, I'll bring it slowly towards you. And you might be able to notice that the letters just get a little bit bigger. Maybe even a little bit clearer for you. Okay, see that? If I take it away, and I put it back in. Away. See a little bit different. Okay. We're just going to go ahead and these two starters. These are going to be a little bit light. They're not going to be too strong, but there's going to be a very small difference with either of them, okay? So, again, I'd like you to focus in on one of these rows. We're going to go ahead and start with maybe row number 4, okay? Now, I'm pretty sure you can see it, but all I'm asking is which of these two lenses you can see better. We're going to start with lens number 1. This is lens number 1. Was lens number 1. This is going to be lens number 2. Which of the two did you like? Very good. Okay. And moving on. These are going to be a bit stronger, but with these, the difference will be a little bit more drastic, okay? Just a little bit, not too much. So, we're going to start off with lens number 1. Okay, that was the lens number 1, and this will be lens number 2. Which of the two did you like? Okay. Are you having a bit of difficulty seeing? Okay. Remember that it's okay not to be able to see with them, so you don't have to feel bad. They're not designed to be able to see with all of them. Even I cannot see very clearly with them. Okay? So, this will be lens number 1. Alright? So, here we go once again. Was lens number 1, and this will be lens number 2. And which of the two did you feel that was better? have a couple more for you. All right. These are going to be a bit different, okay? Just to let you know. But the difference between these two are going to be night and day. They're going to be very different, all right? So, I know it can take a second for your eyes to adjust, but I know you can do this. So, here we go. Here's the first one. Lens number one. Okay. And now this will be lens number two. So here we go once again. Okay, so lens two or lens one? Okay, excellent. Okay, before I do move on, I do have a very special lens for you, much like the red button that I showed you earlier. This is going to be a red lens. This lens, I'm going to put it over your eye. And just like I've been doing already. And you're going to do the same thing. You're just going to look at, you're going to look at line number five. And you're just going to let me know if you can actually see it. Or if it causes you a bit of blurred vision. Maybe it's too dark for you. Maybe you can see it perfectly. You'll let me know, okay? Very good. So let's go ahead. I'm just going to start off from here. You're looking directly into it, okay, from the start. We'll move it right about here so you can kind of see the Snellen chart already. Very good. There you are. And can you read it? All right. And I'll start backing away now. And how was that? Okay, very good. Now, use this one more time. This time, what I want you to do for me is I'm going to bring it close to you. When I bring it close to you, I'm going to bring it away from you. You're going to keep looking at the Snellen chart, and you are going to let me know when you can no longer see through the lens because maybe the lens is too dark or it's too bright for you. Okay? So you let me know whether it's too bright or it's too dark once you can see through it, okay? Very good. So let's go ahead and begin. I'm just going to start out right about here for you. And you should be able to see. Everything should be red, right? Okay. So now you're going to go ahead and let me know when you can't see through the lens anymore. Put my hand down. Stop. Okay. And tell me, what is it about the lens that doesn't let you see? Is it too bright or is it too dark? Okay. It's too dark. Okay. Very good. Excellent. you're doing really well so far, okay? If you'd like, you can close your eyes. I'm going to bring out some cards that I'd like you to read, okay? And we're also going to be using some lenses with these, and we'll see how your vision is recuperating, all right? Sorry there, got a little bit of tongue-tied. Okay. It's okay, you can keep your eyes closed. Sure you've seen these before. Usually they're performed in eye examinations, and I'm sure you've had many in the past. Okay, very well. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to bring out once again the lenses, and you will be letting me know which of the two lenses you can see better with, okay? Just with your eyes. I just want you to take a look at this, okay? And I am going to ask you to please let me know if you can read number 5. What is the word under the number 5? Can you see that? If I hold it right about here. Okay. Difficult or easy? Okay, so now I'm going to give you lens number 1, and you let me, and just try to remember it, because then I will show you lens number 2, and you will pick which of the two lenses is better for you. So, this will be lens number 1, and once again, we're trying to read right about there. We're trying to read the word under lens number, under the number 5. So I'm just going to bring it a little closer to you. Okay. Could you see at that time? That was lens number 1. This is lens number 2. How was that? Your eye is getting a little tired? Okay. Which of the two was better though, if you could? You had to pick one. Okay. All right. And here is your next one. And this time, I'm going to pick. I'm going to stand right about here for you. And I'm going to ask you to read number 21. Can you see number 21? Okay. Now, this is going to be lens number 1. With lens number 1, can you see the word? Number 2. All right. So once again, we're trying to read number 21. 21. Okay. So, which of the two was better for you? Very good. We just got one more set of lens one or lens two, all right? So, let's go ahead and pick a new word. And I'm sure you use this quite often, so it'll be a funny one. Can you read number 31? Okay. Use this lens. This will be our lens number one, and once again, we're trying to read lens number. No, we're trying to read number 31's word. Okay, so we'll place that right about there for you, and this is the word. Lens number one, and this will be lens number two. Okay, again, we're trying to read number 31. Which do you feel was better for you? Did you like lens one or did you like lens two? Excellent. Okay. Let's go ahead and jot that down. Okay. So while I do this, you can, as always, close your eyes, relax. Try to relax and calm down. If you'd like, you can fall asleep as well. Okay. Let's go ahead and just close this. Just like that. And once again, before I actually do leave, going to take a look at your eye again. I've held you up for quite some time at this point today, and I'm sure that you're quite tired, and I'd like you to actually get some rest, okay? I'd like you to get some sleep. So, just going to set this once again, and just going to ask you to please just look straight for me, okay? Just look straight for me, right? And you're just going to, very good, excellent, perfect, very good, all right? Problems with that eye, right? Let's go ahead and take a look at this one. This is our treble eye right here. So, if you will. Very good. Very good. Excellent. Perfect. Eye looks Very good. Very good, very good. Okay. So, you can relax. You can close your eyes once again. I feel like I'm repeating myself quite often, but I like to make sure that the patients know that they can close their eyes. They don't have to focus on me. I know that you're probably feeling a little bit tired, right? You're probably feeling the IV at this point. It does have a mild sedative just to make you feel a little bit more relaxed. Okay, so you can just listen to me if you'd like. Running through all the tests as normal. Seems like a couple things. Just seem like you're just a little tired. Of course, your eyes are going to be a little tired as well, as they also have the numbing, so that your eye doesn't move around too much. And it's perfectly understandable as to why maybe sometimes your eye had a bit of trouble tracking the light, or maybe just moving around in general. So, the only thing that I just asked for you is to just make sure that you have plenty of rest. Now, you are currently in good care here, and all I ask is don't worry about anything. Just try to relax and rest, okay? Very good. So, I don't think that I properly introduced myself, but I was a doctor who took care of you during your surgery, and I am Dr. Hitt. And if you need anything, please don't hesitate and make sure that you give us a ring. Very good. So, you have yourself a good day, and I will be back to check up on you. Excellent. So, thank you.